Hello everyone, welcome back to my GlideApps video series where I talk about Glide templates and business applications built with GlideApps. In this video, we are going to talk about how to create a new project starter template in Glide. I often find myself creating new projects and templates and I have to do some things from scratch every time. So I'm creating a private template to help me kickstart my Glide projects without having to worry about setting up users table and related functions from scratch again. Once this template is ready, if technically possible, I will add a link to this template in the video description below, so you could also kickstart your Glide projects. So here's what I plan to cover as part of this video. We will see how to set up users table, how to edit logged in users profile, how to set up admin views of all users, how to add new users, and how to edit existing users. So let's jump into Glide now. So this is my Glide workspace. I'm going to create a new project and call this project starter. I'm going to say new project starter template, select Glide page, select continue, click on Glide tables to full screen. I'm going to select the desktop layout. I'm going to go to the data editor. You can go to the data editor by clicking this icon in the top left, and I think Alt 1 and Alt 2 also works as keyboard shortcuts. So here what I'm interested in right now is the users tab, and I'm going to quickly create a new one for a home tab as well. Call this home. I'm going to name it new project starter template. Now, as you can see, we have a users table already set up, and this table contains one row with my credentials. You'll notice that in this tab, in this sheet, Glide has automatically set up row owners for email. So I'm going to remove this and I'm going to add a user called John Doe@example.com and call another user Jane Doe. Okay, so now we have a users table ready. Now we are going to quickly see how to set up the basic functionality. So I'm going to get rid of these tabs that Glide created, all of them. I'm going to create two tabs, one for home. I'm going to call it home. I'm going to change the icon to home and change this to custom. I'm going to remove this, right? Simply going to add a hero section so that this does not look ugly. This is okay for now. Let's see how I can enable every user to edit their own profile. So in Glide, when you click this icon in the top right, you will see a button for view profile. Here there's a button for editing my own profile. So let's see what the configuration for this is. Let me drag this to the top. I'm going to delete this, and now let me add an icon here as well. So this is the edit icon, and let me call this edit profile. And I'm going to open this in the slide in menu. So this is where I can change my name, image. I can add a field for phone numbers, blah, 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 and all those things. So now we have quickly seen how a logged in user can edit their own profile. So for example, if I change this for and view this app as John Doe, I will now the ability to edit my own profile if I'm John Doe. So as John Doe, I can upload a picture. I can't change my own axis, but that's for later. So now we have seen how a logged in user can edit their own profile, right? Now let's go back to being Amit, the admin. And now let's see how to add a separate tab to view all the users on the app. So I'm going to click on new. Let's try screen from data and users. Let's see what this pulls up. So not bad, right? Now, first things first, I want this tab to only be visible for people who are admins. So I'm going to click on users in the top left, then click on options, go to the visibility section, add a condition and say user profile role is admin. So now if I'm admin, I can see that there's a section, there's a tab for all the users on the platform, right? Let me change this icon to users. Yeah, this one. Right. So now let's say if I am viewing this as John Doe, I won't be able to see the tab for all the users on the platform. So now I'm going back to being admin. Now let's first look at how to first of all add a new user. So here the title action must have been configured. Clicked on actions. I immediately enabled advanced actions. So I just find it easier that way. And let me quickly change a few things here. Let me delete these additional actions here. And now we are first going to focus on how to add new users. So here it says, under title bar action, I want to enable admins to add a new user. So I'm going to say add a user here, show form screen, and this again is going to be slide in. So when I click this here, instead of saying add item, I'm going to say add a user. So this title at the top, it will say add a user. Now clicking on general again, I have placeholders for name, email, image and role. Now because I am admin, I will allow changing roles, and let's do that by using choice components, right? So I'm going to add an empty table to have some choices. I'm going to call this choices, or you would also call it control. Let's relabel this to roles. And the first one could be admin, staff, customer, or empty, whatever. Now when I'm adding new users to this app, I'll have the option of selecting a role for the user. So this role will, this choice component will write to the role column in the users tab. And the source for this information is going to be choices, and under choices roles, I'm going to select display as roles as well. The default value should be, for example, say staff. I'm going to change the styles to say chips. Now we have completed the functionality where we want to add a new user to the platform. I'm going to click cancel. Let's in fact make some of these fields mandatory. So the name should be required, email should be required, and role is not required, right? So this is done. Now let's see how admins can change the profile of a certain user on the platform. So for example, now I'm trying to edit John Doe's profile as admin. Let me first make this appear in a slide in action as well, because let's stay consistent. Slide in. So John Doe, let the profile say edit user profile, and we can copy the same components actually. So let's go back to add a user, right click all these components here, select select copy all, click cancel, come back to edit and click paste here. So now I have the same options here available, right? So now as admin, I can change this information for any user. So because now a role should only be changed by admins, I'm going to add a visibility condition for the choice component here. So let's say user role is admin. We did not need this when we were trying to add a new user because we have a visibility condition at the top level, at the tab level itself. So anybody who is not an admin will anyway not see a button which says add a user. So now let's come back to being John Doe hide screen and let's see what options we have available when we are trying to edit our profile. So here, as you can see on this component list on the left, I can see the choice component for role, selecting a role, but it's not visible on the screen because now this visibility condition is now coming into play, right? So cool. So we are done with this functionality as well. So now coming back to editing a profile or viewing all users. And now let's also see how to delete a certain user from the platform, right? So we can add that button in a couple of places, or in fact, three places. One is in the user's profile tab here. Let me make the emphasis to be role, the image style to be rounded, medium. This is fine. Here I can add a button to delete the user's profile altogether, but let's see all the options where we can do this. So under actions, I can add another button here which says delete user profile. Here let me pick button which is kind of permission, and the action in this case would be delete row. Right, let me change this to edit user profile so that it's consistent. Let's try and change the view to grid. But when we select grid, we see that the options have jumped here. So let's, or in fact, the list view is not bad as well, right? So cool. So for every user in this list, I have two buttons, two calls to action. One is edit user profile, the other is delete user profile. So let's try and delete Joy Doe. Delete and done. It's gone just like that. We can change this to say that at least show us some notification that the user profile is deleted. So let's come back to actions, come to collection item actions, and in here let's select create new action, and here we can say delete this item and then also show us a notification which says user successfully deleted, right? And let's save this delete user, enable recent runs for custom actions, and let's click on save. So now let's add Joy Doe again first. Joy Doe. And let me say they are just a random person, not staff, not customer, not anybody. And now let's try and delete them again. So delete user profile, and now we see a notification saying user successfully deleted, which is what we wanted, right? In fact, I should not be able to delete myself, right? So let's add a condition here which says show this button only where name, or in fact email, is want signed in user. So for myself, I'm not seeing the delete user profile. So we have taken care of that. Another place where we could have added the delete button was here. Let me select somebody else. And let's add a condition here which says user profile. And I'm going to repeat the same steps of selecting an icon. And I want to delete row, and then I want to show a notification which says user successfully. I'm going to click save. Cool. Now let's see who can see this button. So let's go to my own profile and see if I can see that delete button. No, I can't, right? So let me be John Doe now and see if I see. Cool. Awesome. So it is working as intended. Awesome. So now, yeah, this idea that I started with for this particular video, it now is completely functional. We have seen how to edit our own profile. We have seen how to add new users to the app. We have seen how to edit a user's profile as an admin. Then we have also seen how to delete a user's profile from the platform, right? So hopefully this was useful. Now, before I wrap up this video, I have added a link to this template in the video description below. When you click that link, you will see this particular page. You can view this template as John Doe and see that the users tab or the admin tab for users is invisible. If you view this as me again, you will see that this tab is visible, and you can play around with this particular template here and check out the entire functionality here, right? If you think this template is going to be useful for you, what you can do is you can click on this button which says copy in Glide and then sign in with your Glide account or create a new Glide account if you are new to Glide. So hopefully you guys will also find this template useful for your workflow. I know for sure that this is going to help me speed up or save 20 minutes every time I create a new Glide project. And hopefully you see the same benefits. So again, thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions or feedback, please leave them in the comment section below. If you need help with your Glide apps, links to my expert profile and my Calendly booking page are mentioned in the video description below. If you'd like to purchase my paid templates, a link to a collection of all my Glide templates is also mentioned in the video description below. Again, thank you so much for sticking till the end. I will see you in the next video. Thank you. Cheers. Bye-bye.